Good evening, everyone. I'm Carmine Gemeing. In UW's version of March Madness, the Cowgirls advanced to the second round of the NIT last night, and they play South Alabama at home Sunday at 2 p.m. in round two. And the Poke Wrestlers' season is done at Nationals. They finished in 26th place out of 70 teams and had four guys reach the Sweet 16. Well, as those seasons conclude, our spring high school sports begin. Back here in Casper was the kickoff of the outdoor track and field season for 18 Wyoming teams. And the same teams finished in the top five for boys and girls. Natrona County, Kelly Walsh, Thunder Basin, Rock Springs, and Lander Valley. And the home team, Natrona County, finished first in both the boys and girls team standings. Regardless of results, our athletes are excited to finally see their track and field buddies.
You see people from Rock Springs, and you're like, oh my God, that's my best friend, and she just won. And it's just, it's pretty cool, and it's fun to see everyone, and it's fun to have the meet here and be able to provide this for people.
In my last year, I really want to focus on my teammates and let them know that you don't need to win every meet, and you don't need to be in the top 10. You just need to try your hardest and compete the best you can.
And the Pokes outdoor track and field season also started today. Only the throwers competed in the first day of the Fun McGraw Open in Fort Collins, Colorado. And junior transfer Eric MacArthur won the hammer throw. He got that thing down there 192 feet 10 inches. And that was more than a foot further than second place. Kirk Unland reached third, and Hatford Kettish took fifth. The rest of the Poke track stars compete tomorrow. And back in Casper, another tough sport, judo. A grappling art involving throws, joint locks, chokes, and pins to beat the opponent. Well, two weekends ago, this group sent nine kids to Scholastic Youth Nationals at the Olympic Training Center in Colorado Springs. And they earned five medals. One gold, two silvers, and two bronzes. That's at the top tournament in the country. Justin Smith started teaching judo out of the garage at the Mills Police Department. And now he's got almost 50 kids taking his class twice a week in the basement of the old YMCA. Justin and his staff are all volunteers, and what a service to the community. The classes are free to the kids as long as they're members of the YMCA.
Although it's an individual sport, and like I said, it's a combat sport, very tough in an individual athletic arena, all the time and everything leading up to that point in time, it takes a team, it takes a dojo, it's a community, you know, to build up and help each other get ready.
It felt really good because I'd worked so hard for it in practice, so I definitely it felt really great to get it.
It's not always going to be easy, and it gave me the confidence to keep learning and doing more judo, get better and better.
In high school, we've got a big award to announce. Bighorn senior Cade Van Dyken just earned the Wyoming Football Scholar Athlete of the Year Award. Cade ranked second in his class of 34 students at Bighorn. He's got a 3.975 GPA and scored a 29 on his ACT. On the football field, many of you know Bighorn won the 1A state title, and Cade was a big part of that at wide receiver. During his career, he accounted for 19 touchdowns with 87 receptions for 1,340 yards. A great scholar athlete right there. And a big game for the Avalanche last night at the Dallas Stars, fighting for a wild card spot. Second period, no score. Colin Wilson drops it back to Samuel Girard. He hits Eric Johnson for the one-timer, and he scores. Avs up 1-0. Then same score, 5 minutes left. Girard gets the puck, splits the defense, then finds Tyson Berry on the wing. Top shelf, he scores the wrister. That made it 2-0 Avs. Then 2-1 with less than a minute left, and the big man, Carl Soderberg, gets the puck, fires it down, and he scores on the empty net. Soderberg mobbed by the Avs. They get the big win 3-1, and now the Avs move into the second wild card spot in the Western Conference, meaning playoffs. But they've got to stay there, playing the Blackhawks tomorrow afternoon. And in our March Madness bracket, it's getting hot. Ryan Berger and Hallie's dad are tied for first, with only four picks wrong through 31 games.
Wait, am I Jones part two?
You're Jones part two in third, and then I'm tied for fourth. Everyone else is in the top half of all brackets in the world, except poor GMW weatherman, David Furtado. He is in 11th. He's only in the 11th percentile in the world with 11 picks wrong. Not very good.
Not very good at all.
I'm glad I'm winning.
I'm glad I'm part two, Jones. So with that, thank you, Carmine. We'll be right back after the break.